Hey guys and welcome back to another lecture of Dental Pathshala where we help you understand and learn dentistry better and easy way. And this video we are going to talk about oral radiology. So without further ado, let's get started. Lovely students, today we are going to talk about the most interesting topic, which is the latent image formation. You are going to love it because all the physics we have read till now, whatever we have read till now, we are going to apply it and see how the image is formed. So we know that by now that when the x-ray photon or the primary beam is projected, this is from the x-ray tube. So when this x-ray beam is projected onto the tissues, what happens? So we see that suppose this is the X-ray photon which is coming, right? Some of the photon, most of the photon I must say, it is absorbed in the bone, right? So some of the photon, it gets scatters. So this is our scattering, and below this we have got the film. So what happens? We see that here little sum of the photon is coming out on the film. So this is our film. So before we get started, make sure you subscribe to our channel and click on the bell icon so that you don't miss any of our future notifications. I completely forgot because I just love this concept and I'm so eager to teach you about it. You're going to love it. So what happens when the X-ray photon is coming? Now we know that X-ray is a photon, right? So what happens when the beam is coming? Now we have studied till now that there is a Compton effect. Compton effect is what? Wherein the radiation is coming and it is getting scattered. The Compton scattering, if you remember, how does this happen? We are going to talk about in a bit. So what happens? Whenever there is a dense area which is present, suppose there is a bone which is present, the tissue density wherever it is more. So the X-ray has got the tendency to keep it with it. So that means the X-ray cannot pass out from the dense objects. X-ray cannot pass from bone. Not much of the X-rays can pass. Rather than that, it can easily pass from the fat. It can easily pass from the air. Right, so all of the soft tissues X-ray can pass, but not the hard tissues. Hard tissue actually are going to absorb it. So what do we see in this case? The all of the radiation which is coming on the film is producing the dark area, and the radiation which is not coming on the film is going to produce, so the energy which is absorbed here, I'm going to mark it, right? So this is the energy, this is the photon which is absorbed by the bone will give us the radio opacity. We know this, right? So all of the hard structures like the bone, they are usually radio opaque. We know that the hard structures are radio opaque and the soft structures are radiolucent, right? Now we are going to see how it happens. Why these structures are radiolucent? What happens in this X-ray film that it becomes radiolucent? What happens in the bone that, what happens in the X-ray film that all of these structures which are dark, which have got a high density, these structures, they are not giving any image. They are producing the radio opaque. What happens? So I'm going to tell you. The radiation which are absorbed are going to create the brightness or are going to create the white image because there is no X-ray which is falling. The X-ray which is crossing the tissues and coming on the film, okay, these X-ray radiation, they produces darkness or there is a decrease in the brightness. So what happens? These X-rays which are coming, okay, the silver film, we know that there is a film, X-ray film. X-ray film, I've told you in the last video, remember the emulsion, I have made it from the red color and I've shown a demo also how the film is composed of. So there are silver halide grains which are present in the gelatin matrix. If you remember, I've told you this. So we have got the silver halide grains which are in the gelatin matrix. These silver halide grains, I've told you this, this silver halide grains are composed majorly of silver bromide, that is 95% to 98%, and rest of that there is a sulfur contamination which is there. So basically what we know, that there is an emulsion which is present in the film. This emulsion has got silver halide. You know what silver is? White in color. You have seen, no? Always all the ornaments, the color of the silver which is white in color. You know what happens? This X-ray which is coming on the film, this X-ray which is crossing the tissue and reaching up till the film, these X-ray, the silver takes it. And when, you know that, when a high energy photon is coming, then there is electron which comes out of its shell, because this and high energy photon will kick out the electron out of the shell. And once the electron is out of its shell, we know that there is some movement going on. Immediately we catch it. Immediately we catch all the movement of the silver, whatever silver, we just catch it. When it is taken out of its house, we catch it and we develop it. So wherever the silver is not present, wherever because of the electron, this area, suppose this particular area in the film, there were silver halide crystals, okay? There were silver halide crystals here also. So what happens? You have to listen it carefully, okay? This silver halide crystals, when the film is falling on the silver halide crystal, now what happens? Because there is an interaction, because this high energy photon is going to kick out the electron in this particular area, right? We know that. We have studied the Compton effect, the photoelectric effect. I'm going to tell you in detail. But what happens when the light is coming, these atoms, these grains of silver atom, because there is some movement going on. So silver is out right now and we are going to catch it. We are going to remove it. So all these areas, the silver is gone from here. We know that silver is white in color. So this is the reason that wherever the X-ray photon is imparted there, because silver is not there, so there is a darkness. So this is the reason that where the X-ray is falling, we are immediately going to catch all the silver, because their movement is going on, right? Movement we are going to study. We'll talk about it, the electron wave. We are going to, in a bit, we are going to read it. So the main important thing is that where X-ray is falling, here there is some movement because of the X-ray, right? Because of the photon. Because photon is going to strike the atom and there will be electron will go out. So basically there is some movement we'll talk about. So this, because of this movement, the silver is out right now. We are going to catch it, remove it. We are going to remove the silver. So once we remove the silver, we have got the silverless area, which is causing the dark color. So this is basically how the image is produced. This is just the rough idea I've told you, or you can say in the layman terms, to make it easier for you to understand. So what happens when the X-ray is falling, silver which has got white color, now that the X-ray is taking the silver out, this is just for you to understand things, okay? I'm going to tell you in detail. This is not how it happens. This is not how you are going to write in the exam. This is for your understanding. I'm going to tell you how you are going to write an exam, but for time being, remember this, that when the X-ray is coming, the silver, there is a movement because of the high energy photon, and we are catching this movement. We are catching the thief. Once we catch the thief, the area is empty now. Because of that, it is just the dark color. Right? Now we know that. That wherever the radiation is, X-ray radiation is transmitted. See, this white is wherein there is absorbed, right? Because the bone is absorbing. So this absorbed radiation is going to create the radio opacity, because silver here is present. He is fit and fine. He is dancing nicely. And what happens wherein there was a raid by the police. So imagine that this X-ray is the police or the cops. So they are going to attack somewhere. Once they attack, all the area is vanished. So there is no dark area which is left in the X-ray film. And wherever this, suppose these are the cops, these are the police, wherever, whichever area they attack, all the darkness is gone from that area. So this is basically when the transmitted radiation is falling onto some area and this transmitting radiation is falling to the film. That means there is going to be radiolucent area in that particular site of the image. Now let's talk about the latent image formation. So let's understand the concept. So to save our time, I have already made a structure. So what is there? We have got the emulsion layer. In the emulsion layer, we have got the silver halide grains, right? These silver halide grains are present in the gelatin matrix. Now these silver halide grains, they contain, you remember in the last video we have already talked about that, in the composition we have talked about. So in the composition of the X-ray film, there is a in the silver halide crystals, so 95% to 98% there are AgBr which is present, right? Silver bromide, this is present with, I told you, with the sulfur contamination. So in that there are some sulfur contaminations which are already present. So in the AgBr there is some sulfur which is present. Also, you know what, there are free Ag ions which are present. So basically these are the silver ions which are floating, which are dancing, which are enjoying in this crystal lattice, okay, who are free, who are not caged. So also we have got some Ag. So what happens when there is a photon which is coming? Suppose there is a photon which comes, right? This is the X-ray photon. Now we know that in the Compton effect, photoelectric effect, we have studied this. When the X-ray photon comes and strike on the atom, it is going to eject one electron. It is going to take out the electron out of his shell. So we have got some sites which are present in this crystal lattice. So these sites are the sites which are the sites of contamination, which has got the sulfur contamination. So these sites, we call it the sensitive sites, because these are very sensitive. They have got sulfur. So you can remember S for sulfur, S for sensitive. So these are very sensitive. So this electron, which is because of the X-ray photon, out of its house, he is looking for a new house. What he saw is that, he see that there is something different. There are some people, there is some kind of energy. So he goes there. Once he goes there, once this electron goes to the sensitive site, he gets trapped. He's trying to go out, he cannot go out. So he's trapped inside this house. Now, because this is, now there is an electron, so this site becomes negative. Now this is only one crystal atom which I have shown you. There are many crystal atoms which are present. Right, there are many lattice structure which are present and many photons which are coming, right? So because of that, it get the negative charge. Now that it is negative charge, so negative charge is always looking for the positive charge. Whenever there is a lot of negativity, then there is a god who appears. So like that, a positive power comes. So there is a free floating positive power we have already got in the lattice structure, which is our free silver. So the free silver ion, it sees that there is a lot of negativity going on somewhere, I should go there. So this silver, free silver ion goes inside and make it neutral. Now this sensitive site, which was earlier negative, now it is neutral. Now like that, we have got so many. So this particular neutral structure, in which there is silver ion, in which there is electron, and now the silver ion has balanced the electron, so this has become the neutral metallic silver atom. So this is basically has become the neutral. In this we have got free silver atoms, right? In this particular structure, we have got the neutral metallic silver atom. So this particular site, we call it the latent image site, wherein there were, because of the X-ray photon, the electron get trapped. So these were kind of a villain. Then somehow this negativity, there was a negativity which got developed, and this negativity, Ag positive atoms which were free floating in the lattice structure, they saw that there is some negativity going on. So they goes inside. So they goes inside to make it positive. So they just overpower them, so that all the negative got cut off because of the silver positive ion. So all of that become now neutral. This neutral structure, which is at the sensitive site, we call it the latent image site. So this is one particular site. Like that we have got many crystals, like that we have got many sites. So all these latent sight, we call it together the latent image. So guys, this is the production of the latent image. But the story doesn't stop here. Now that there is, now the, you know, the life cycle, we always keep on telling, the life cycle repeats itself, right? So what happens? We still didn't get the image, right? So how do we get the image? We have to get the image when we put it in the developer, when we put it in the processor, when we are doing the processing, basically developer and the fixer. So what happens? This latent image site is there. Then we are going to put it in the developer solution. So this is our developer solution. Now developer solution has got phenidone. So we are going to talk about when we are doing the processing. I'm going to give you the mnemonics for that. So which is our phenidone. So phenidone, which is our developer. So we have got some silver halide, some neutrals. I must say some neutral silver atoms. Now this phenidone will give its electron again. So I told you, life cycle repeat itself. So again it gives its electron. When these electrons, they go and they attack this particular site, this particular latent image site. So there is a conversion of the solid grains of the silver into the metallic silver. So all of the grains, latent image, is now converted into metallic silver. And I'll tell you one more thing, one interesting fact. You know what? These people, they sell the developer solution. And from this developer solution, some people, I don't know what they do, they take out the metallic silver. So this is the story which I've heard, that people sell the used developer solution because they can take out metallic silver from that. And this is the reason, because the grains, silver halide grains, which were initially, now are converted into metallic silver in the developer solution. Right? Now we are going to put it into the fixer. Now here the story changes, okay? Because in the fixer we have got the ammonium thiosulfate. So this is the fixer. So this is ammonium thiosulfate. Ammonium thiosulfate. So we have got ammonium thiosulfate in the fixer. Now what happens? These ammonium thiosulfate is going to act on the crystals which are not exposed. So all the area which is not exposed, all the area wherein the X-ray didn't even strike, all the areas beneath the bone, beneath the dense areas. So all these areas, this ammonium thiosulfate will go, because silver is still present like that. Is going to act on the silver and make the silver thiocyanate. Now this silver thiocyanate, which is made once we wash it with the water, this is the reason that after developing the X-ray, we wash it in the water. So all the silver thiosulfate on that, from that, all that is washed out. So I hope that now it is clear how the image is developed. I hope that now you understand it better, what is the procedure of the latent image formation. So what happens when the X-ray photons, when the X-ray photon is coming at the high speed? You remember we have already studied that when the photon is coming at little bit lower speed, then only there is going to be just the vibration of the electron, and there is a radiation like that, which was our coherent scattering. So coherent scattering was when there is just the vibration. So like that, we are not talking right now about it, because we are taking all the radiations which are crossed the tissue, which have crossed. So these are the high energy radiations. Though all these high energy radiation are going to kick out the electron from its shell, from the bromide, and bromide is going to attack or caged inside, trapped inside all the sensitive site. These sensitive site, S for sensitive, S for sulfur, has got the sulfur or the contaminations. It is trapped inside. Then it is going to, make it all negative, because it is so negative. So all this negativity which he spreads inside the sensitive site, then the Ag positive, which is the silver ion, it sees that. Well, he is creating so negativity, then he goes inside, makes it neutral. We call it the latent image site. And like that, we have got in one, if you see one silver halide, in one silver halide also, we have got multiple AGBR lattice structure. 10 to the power something, so much. So we have got so many sites, we call it the latent image. Actually what happens, this ammonium thiosulfate, when it combines with the silver halide crystals which are not exposed, it forms the silver thiocyanate. And the silver thiocyanate, once it is formed, the silver thiocyanate is washed out. So the silver is actually washed out. But to make it easier for you to understand, I am just telling you this story. Right, so this is how the latent image is formed. I hope that you have enjoyed this video. So if you have enjoyed this video, then give it a thumbs up. Also, you can comment in the comment section below. There is a link in the description box below to support me on Patreon as well as on PayPal to make free videos for you guys and to make free notes. So till then, keep reading, keep learning, stay motivated. I'll see you soon in the next video.